Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Jen from Modified Macros here. Today we're going to be talking about intermittent fasting and the ketogenic diet. So intermittent fasting, or IF as you're going to see it all over the place, is basically where you have a fasted state and an eating window. You'll normally see people call it things like 16-8. That means 16 hours where you're not eating or you're in your fasted state, in 8 hours where you're going to be consuming all your calories. Don't freak out. When I first heard about this, I got a little scared. I don't like people telling me I can only eat in certain times, but it actually makes sense because you're getting a lot of the value of fasting without having to actually go a full day without eating. Intermittent fasting is not only used for the ketogenic diet, it just happens to work really well with it. It's used by dietitians and nutritionists across all different types of diets. It's used in many, many different cultures and eating plans, and it has been used for decades. There are a lot of benefits that come with fasting naturally. There's something called autophagy, that is when your cells eat themselves or recycle themselves. It helps with longevity and staying healthy. There's links and studies to fasting and reducing cancer. It helps with your metabolism. When you are in a fasted state, your body naturally produces more of the human growth hormone. You've probably seen people supplement their diets or add that to help boost metabolism. Your body naturally does that when you're in a fasted state. It also helps with insulin resistance. If you are an insulin resistant person, fasting or being in that fasted state helps to reset and helps to heal that. There's also all sorts of studies that show that fasting is great for reducing cardiovascular disease. It helps with sleep patterns. It just helps a lot. There are so many healthy benefits to fasting, and intermittent fasting is a way to kind of captivate some of those qualities without having to actually fast for days on end. So by having an eating window and a fasted window, you get as much of that as you can without actually having to not eat for days. So it works so well with the ketogenic diet, you guys, because when we're in our fasted state in keto, that is when our body is burning fat for fuel. People see amazing results when they add IF to their ketogenic diet, because the longer you're in that fasted state, the longer your body is burning its own fat for fuel. So people love it. So here is my advice for intermittent fasting. I made a really big mistake when I first started. So let me tell you what my nutritionist told me. If you are just starting keto, it can be very tempting to start out immediately with intermittent fasting. But my nutritionist warned me against it, and here is why. She let me know that it takes up to 30 days. Really, it could take up to 60 or 90, but that first 30 days of keto is incredibly critical to you getting fat adapted. That's the state where your body's gonna start really burning fat for fuel. You're gonna feel fat adapted when you have an energy increase, you're sleeping better, you stop being as hungry, and your keto flu symptoms start to dissipate. Getting fat adapted is absolutely critical to success on the ketogenic diet. So for your first 30 days, focus on that. Don't focus on, I have to eat between this time and this time, and I have to have all my calories here. That could be a lot of stress. You're already rewriting your whole metabolic blueprint here. We're going from what we've done our whole lives of eating carbs and the standard American diet to using fat for a fuel source. So give your body that 30 days to kind of adjust. But the good news about that is you're almost always going to naturally find your best IF pattern. Here's where I made my mistake. I followed the crowd. Everyone on social media was saying 12 p.m. to 8 p.m. That's your 8 hour window for the 16-8. And I thought, okay, that's what everybody else is doing. I'll do it too. I was miserable. I wake up at 5:30 Monday through Friday, 5:30 a.m. And I start my workday at 7 a.m. Like, I have to be on and going at 7 a.m. I'm usually winding down to my bedtime routine around 8:30, 9 o'clock. So for me, not eating until noon, that's like 6 to 6.5 hours that I'm awake that I'm not eating. I would be hangry and miserable, and I hated it. And then I found I don't really like to eat past 6 o'clock, but I'd be trying to force myself to eat at 7, 8 o'clock, which would set back my sleep pattern. So when I went and met with my nutritionist and she asked me how I liked it, I told her I hated it. And I thought that meant I hated intermittent fasting. And she said, then why are you eating in that time window? And I said, because I thought I was supposed to. Everyone else is doing that. And she said, no. So here's my advice to you. Listen to your body. The thing I love, love, love most about keto, you guys, is that it is so personal. What works for one person isn't going to work for the next person, but that's good. Listen to your body and pay attention to when you're hungry. I'm hungry earlier in the day. I'm actually the hungriest between 2 or 3. And I used to think that's because everyone said that's when you would have sugar drops and all that. But it's not. That's just when my body is the hungriest. And I found if I eat a big meal between 3 and 4 p.m., I don't want to eat for the rest of the night. I can literally have a cup of tea around 7 p.m. and I'm good. I'm fine. My body's okay with that. And I prefer to start eating earlier, closer to anywhere from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., but earlier if I want to. I adjust my windows based on how I'm feeling, how my body is feeling, how my body is telling me what I should be doing. If I'm starving and it's 7:30, I'm gonna start my eating window at 7:30. So my IF window right now is somewhere between 8 and 5 p.m. You can do all sorts of different windows, you guys. The 8-hour window is where we start, but people will shorten. Some people do a 7-hour, 6-hour, 4-hour. There's something called the OMAD lifestyle. It stands for one meal a day. It's kind of a misnomer. A one meal a day is usually a 4-hour eating window where you're getting all of your calories, get all of your macros in 4 hours. A lot of people do, a big snack and a big meal or something like that to do it. But those are the IF windows that you're mostly going to fall into. So a 4-hour, a 6-hour, or an 8-hour are the most common. For the rest of that time, you are in a fasted state. That is when your body is very happy when you're on the ketogenic diet. So here are some tips to kind of help you save off that hunger a little bit in the morning. I wake up in the morning and the very first thing I do is drink 16 to 20 ounces of water. Now I have mine with exogenous ketones. I talk about it all the time, very unapologetically in my videos because they have helped me tremendously. I do have Hashimoto's. I also have a lot of systemic inflammation. I have some arthritis, and it has helped me tremendously. Exogenous ketones are also great because they're a natural appetite suppressant, and that extra jolt of ketones in the morning lights my brain on fire. I am ready to go. But if you don't use exogenous ketones, if you're fully against them or you don't understand what they are, you can just do water. So start your day with 16 to 20 ounces of water. Again, mine are exogenous ketones, and my raspberry lemonade is what I'm doing right now. It tastes amazing. Then I have my coffee. So you don't want to break your fasted state, and the general consensus is anything under 50 calories should keep you good. There is a lot of debate whether or not bulletproof coffee will break your fast. I happen to live in Seattle and Bulletproof is in Bellevue, which is about 20 minutes from me. I've been there. I've talked to the founders. He says that Bulletproof is made to break a fast. It has well over 200 calories in a traditional Bulletproof coffee. It happens to break my fast. I know that because I've done blood panels. So I stay away from Bulletproof coffee. I either have my keto cream, you can do a little bit of half and half, a little bit of heavy whipping cream, and some of your keto approved sweeteners, so you can have coffee in the morning. Coffee is also one of those natural appetite suppressors, so it helps to keep you fuller longer so that you can hold that fast for as long as you can. I also recommend staying busy, you guys. I front load my mornings. I get all of that work that I know I'm going to like doing, so meetings with coworkers that I enjoy talking to, things like that, I front load in the morning so I keep my mind off of the fact I haven't eaten yet. I run errands that I need to run early in the morning so that I can kind of have that time where I'm in the fasted state and I'm running around so I don't notice it as much. Just keep your mind busy. And that also helps with the hunger in the morning. When your first meal comes around and you break your fast, I prefer to be very intentional with my fats. My first meal of the day is really loaded with those heart-healthy, unsaturated fats that are just what my body is craving after being in the fasted state for 16 hours. So I usually break my fast with a more fat heavy meal in the morning. I save my carb heavy meals for the mid-afternoon when I'm most active. And then for dinner, I have a really nice balance of my macros with my protein, my fat, and my carbs. For nighttime, like I said, tea helps me so much. And I'm not even a tea drinker per se, but I found there's like some really great decaf flavored teas. I have one that tastes like iced lemon loaf. I have one that tastes like sugar cookies. I love decaf English breakfast tea. Like, I'll just have a cup of tea. I also have bone broth. Sometimes I'll have that if I keep it under the 50 calories. I'm not worried about it breaking my fast. So if I feel like I need a little something to get me through the night, I'll do that. And then I just put myself into a wind down routine. And usually when your body knows it's winding down, then you're gonna not be as hungry. I also want to remind you guys that hunger is not a constant thing. It comes in waves. So one of our rules is ride the wave. Wait it out, drink water, have some tea, something like that to kind of get through that wave, and then it usually will dissipate and go away. Some of my other tips, you guys, for fasting is listen to your body, pay attention to your windows, and then enjoy it. If you guys are doing this and you hate it, stop. Intermittent fasting is not required. Or adjust your window so that you do like it. You're never gonna keep up a lifestyle, you guys, that you hate doing. If you are hangry every day and your coworkers are like, enough, or your kids are like, enough, you're not going to continue doing this. That's why at Modified Macros, I always say, modify your diet to your lifestyle, never your lifestyle to your diet. Make sure that you work with what works for you. It doesn't matter if your 9 other friends go 12 to 8, if you're better earlier in the morning or even later, if you don't want to start eating until 2 and you only want to eat until 8, make the windows what works for you. I follow intermittent fasting Monday through Friday, and then on Saturday and Sundays, I'm usually a lot more relaxed with it. So that's another option for you guys. On Saturdays, I honestly usually don't have my first meal until lunchtime, and it's just because I'm so busy. I also drink more coffee on Saturday than I do on other days, not because I need it, because I actually really enjoy drinking coffee. And then on Sundays, I usually wake up and we have a big family breakfast, so I start waking and eating almost immediately on Sundays. So I'm a little more relaxed with my intermittent fasting on weekends, but it's up to you. Do what works for you, what's best for your lifestyle. For me, being really strict Monday through Friday is very easy to do. It keeps me in a routine. And then giving myself leeway on Saturday and Sunday helps a lot. I usually have a shorter eating window, like I said, on Saturday, and then on Sunday, I don't follow any intermittent fasting at all, traditionally. Okay, guys, so that is my best advice and tips for intermittent fasting with the ketogenic diet. If you have any questions, of course, you can always comment. You can visit me at my Facebook group at any time. I am always involved there. I'm very responsive. And thanks for tuning in.